Happy Friday. Welcome to Great Day Connecticut. You made it.
I'm completely exhausted from this morning's live shot. That's all I got to be. It just sucks the energy right out of you. That Chaz and AJ, they'll take it right out of you.
Come on, it's a nice toy drive.
It was a great toy drive, but it's just so.
I heard you did some singing.
Yeah, we did do a little singing. We're gonna get to that in just a second. But first, have you seen the bear and the reindeer?
I haven't. I know you're really excited about this video, so I wanted to see it with all of you at home. Let's see about. There's a bear versus a reindeer.
This is in California. This is great. Look at that. The bear is attacking the reindeer. It is fantastic. The lawn ornament is going down. And the bear is like, yeah, you think you're king of the neighborhood? He's like, I'll take care of you. Is this the best? Look at this. Look at it. He's wrestling with the reindeer. It's the best thing ever. And he takes it down.
I think there's a second bear watching him.
Yeah, of course there is a second bear watching him. He's like, is it safe yet? Is it safe to go in the yard? Absolutely fantastic. The bear and the reindeer.
Yeah, that must be a high-quality inflatable, because I would have
thought it really didn't
burst.
Go down. Right?
Well, you think with a bear's claws, it would have just popped?
That just popped. Either that or the bear was just being friendly.
I don't know what brand of inflatable they have.
Or playing around, but that is quite something. Unbelievable.
All right, so you were off. There was a wonderful toy drive for WPLR, Chaz and AJ, and I know that was this morning. I don't know if people can still donate online, but...
Yes, they can donate online. Just go to Chaz and AJ, WPLR. It was so much fun, and we got to do our Saturday Night Fever. I can't remember the name of the song. I sang it. I can't... Well, let's roll the tape. Maybe I'll hear it and I'll remember it. Oh, yeah. It was terrible. It was absolutely terrible.
Though you did not want me to.
It's awful. Just, I know. Cover your ears.
There was a man here.
Nights on Broadway. Thank you, Bob. Yeah, I can't believe I forgot the name of it. That's me in the background. Then. All right, that's enough. Thank you.
Okay.
Well, you know what? We raised money. We raised a bunch of toys. People were coming in. They loved it, and they were having a great time. So it's fantastic.
Okay. This is very nice of you to do.
Yeah, it was great. It was all great. It was all great.
All right.
Thank you for everybody who showed up at like 5:30, 5 o'clock this morning. They were there. It was unbelievable.
I think it was just our audio. I'm sure it sounded better.
Oh, no, Kara. It didn't sound any better than that. Trust me when I say that.
All right, so it's National Lager Day.
I don't understand what the difference is between lager. I guess lager is different than beer. Is that true?
I guess. What?
Cold filtered.
It's cold filtered. Well, thank you, Ernie.
Okay.
Oh, there it is. The cold conditioning process used to make lagers distinguishes it from other beer. I did not know that.
It can
that.
Be pale, amber, or dark.
Okay. So now when you go to a bar, do you say...
They're often described as crisp and refreshing because they're lighter.
But when you order a drink, do you say, I want a lager, or do you say, I want a beer? And then they say, well, we have a lager. I've never heard them differentiate. Yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't
anyway,
drink.
It's National Lager Day.
It's National Lager Day. Have a great day.
Looking for something fun to do this holiday season, it's always great to go down to New York City and check out the window displays. And this year, they are really pulling out all the stops after.
Oh, my
this
God.
This is, I think, in years past with, is this this year? Because otherwise, Saks Fifth Avenue always does the
amazing. Yeah, Saks Fifth Avenue does this. This
that
is
actually,
amazing.
Reminds me, It's this year. Oh, okay.
God bless.
All right. I went down to see it last year, and it looked amazing.
I cannot believe I worked in that building, Saks Fifth Avenue. I cannot believe that was a career ago, that was a lifetime ago, that I was an assistant buyer in contemporary denim. That was my department. I bought contemporary denim.
Contemporary denim, okay.
Yeah, I was an assistant buyer in Saks Fifth Avenue, and that's where I worked. On the ninth floor. There's no reason to laugh, Rich. It was a very...
It wasn't just regular denim. It was contemporary denim.
It was contemporary denim.
It's a and very I was specific like, buying role.
And that's when I said, I don't think I belong here. I don't think I fit in.
Was it the corduroys and the plaid
pants?
No,
it was like the get...
That you
I remember
didn't
one
fit
of
in?
Our guest jeans, get used. These were all some of the, you know, the big jean trends.
That's all I wanted for Christmas, I think, in fifth grade. I begged and begged for
and
guest
when
jeans.
You were in the fifth grade, I was working at Saks.
See, there you go.
There you go.
You were picking out my contemporary denim
all
that
right.
I wanted.
So you can check out the windows. Macy's, Jamie, our executive producer, was 7 at the time. That's a little scary. And somebody came up to me today and said at the toy drive, when are you retiring? I'm like, am I that old? Like, literally asked me, are you retiring soon? I'm like, do I need to retire? I think it's so
Maybe
funny.
Maybe it's just because Bruce retired.
I don't know. But I'm like, I'm 57. I'm not 87.
Well,
I don't know. I said, they're going to take me out of here in a box. This is going to happen. Unbelievable.
All right, so if you want KFC's iconic herbs and spices in a fire log,
I do not.
Because this is the thing that people wait for all year. You can go to walmart.com. It's only $16, and you too can have the smell of KFC in your living room.
Unless it's a Connecticut agricultural product, I'm not interested. See that? Yes, they're coming
Very
up a
nice.
Little bit later on in the show. But the KFC log will smell like chicken. What does it smell like, Kara?
The special spices blend.
Special spices blend? All right. I have a cranberry
You can also get a themed vacation getaway with KFC. You can go for 3 days and a two-night stay for 8 people in a 7,000-square-foot luxury log cabin in Kentucky.
That doesn't sound like running water to me, but what do I know?
Well, I'm sure you're going to get some KFC in that luxury cabin.
I guess so. You'll be eating
Kentucky's
KFC.
Kentucky's pretty.
Kentucky is pretty. Just a log cabin sounds kind of rustic.
Maybe it's like glamping. You get nice things.
Do you get nice things? Okay, we'll have to check it out.
You got to at least have a microwave to heat up the KFC.
This whole story is just sad to me.
Yeah,
this whole Jussie Smollett story.
So it came down with the verdict yesterday. The former Empire actor Jussie Smollett was found guilty on 5 counts of disorderly conduct from making false police reports. This is all related back to 2019 when they say he lied to police and made up reports that there were slurs against him, anti-gay and racist slurs, and that
he
put a noose around his neck and that it was just all a story. Now, he apparently held his face, didn't show much of emotion. His attorneys say they're appealing the decision, but he was found guilty.
Well, what did he want? He wanted to become more famous.
That's what they're saying. They're saying he wanted sympathy, publicity.
That's what he got. He's getting a lot of publicity for it now, which is just the whole thing is just unfortunate. Let's move on.
All right, so you know how once upon a time you were a contemporary denim buyer?
Yes.
Well, Elon Musk was a teaching assistant.
At the University of Pennsylvania.
Yeah, at the Wharton School of Business. And guess what? He graded papers.
If I had one of his papers graded, I would get $7,000 for it.
Yeah, they're going off now. The Elon Musk graded papers are selling online for a lot of money. I mean, like as high as $7,000. So if you happen to have him as a teacher at one point and you still have your paper, it's worth money.
Now, if you have a Scott Haney paper, because I was a TA at Syracuse University, that could be worth like $2. So you might want to check.
What did you teach?
Introduction to Broadcast Journalism.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I was a TA.
Teaching assistant. But that's what he was. He was a teaching assistant.
That's what I did. I graded the papers.
TA, like, all that.
Taught the classes, and it was a lot of fun. I had a good time.
Okay.
Yeah, Eric Stengel was one of my students. He went on to be the head writer for David Letterman for all those years. He was my student, and I wrote on the top of his paper, "You are so clever, you have no idea how talented you are."
Oh, so maybe you helped him.
I don't know, but I think I may still have one of his papers. Maybe I'll sell that for $3. Anyway, so that's what that is.
All right, Time has chosen its 18-year-old songwriter as the
God
Entertainer of the Year, Olivia Rodrigo.
God bless her.
She's Entertainer of the Year. She's a teen pop star. Sometimes she's been compared to Taylor Swift or Carly Simon, Alanis Morissette. I know they're all different, but that's
18 years old, right? God bless her. That is an incredible accomplishment. And she's got a Grammy. What is she? She's up for like for Grammys. She stayed on top for 8 weeks of the Billboard Top 100. Her first single, Driver's License, released in January that same month. She became the youngest solo artist to debut at number one on the Billboard Top 100. She's up for 7 Grammy Awards, Kara. Unbelievable.
It's amazing. And only 18 years old.
And Simone Biles is the Time People, I think it's the Athlete of the Year.
Yep.
As you know, she triumphed and still came home with 2 gold medals despite the fact that she had some issues in the Olympics.
Yeah, and she stood bravely for saying, I'm just not up for this.
Yep.
And she had what was called the twisties. She also spoke out about sexual abuse.
Yep.
So she's really...
She's an inspiration. She's a role model. Good for her. God bless her. I'm glad she won.
Speaking of athletes, very tough day for the UConn Huskies.
No, so
they lost
sad.
Their first game without star player Paige Beckers.
Yep, and you know AZ Fudd is out, and Nikki Mule. I hope I got her name right, but there's like 3 or 4 of these young ladies are injured right now. The team is really suffering. I think it's Nico Mule. But anyway, AZ Fudd, Paige Becker, Nikki Mule, they're all out, and there's another player as well. So they're really not doing well. And it was like, I think the first time they lost in 239 games. which is really
upsetting. Against an unranked player,
an unranked team.
Yeah, for sure.
And they have two more competitors coming up that are even a little bit harder than these teams, than this particular team. So we're just gonna have to wait and see what happens.
Let's wish them well. Maybe they can still come together.
Let's rally for the ladies. Rally for the ladies. We hope they do well.